Right on.
You like you play tennis and shit. You're like, I gotta go to the tennis court. You're laughing at Ovia. You're tired. You better be there. You better just be going like that.
Little bit of kickball.
Welcome to this edition of Community Influences. I am your host, The Millen, and we in the building, and we about to catch a feeling. Today we got a very special guest, and she's a part of the comedy movement that's in the Bay Area. And her name is?
Glamis Rory.
How you doing, Miss Rory?
I'm doing pretty good, Jamel. How are you?
That music sounds good in the background. Yeah. Oh, man, I just hope it come out, you know, when it, you know, as far as recording and sound. But
me too, because like one of my favorite comedians, a lot of everybody's favorite comedian, Richard Pryor, right? See, that's why I say I need this shit because my voice goes low when I get in my voice, right? But, yeah, you know, he would get on stage and he would just open the story to the world.
Right.
You know, and I think, you know, from what I've learned about comedy, I think that's a, would you say that's a big part of comedy, being honest?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, but some people have gimmicks. You know, some people are gimmicks.
We talked about that before.
Right, we talked about that. Some people are gimmicks. I'm not calling out any names. But, you know, and it works.
Right.
And that's, you know, and they tell whatever they tell.
Right.
But again, it works. And then some people tell their true life story. You know, so.
Right, and then.
And then there's a little bit of both sometimes.
Right. And then, you know, they tell their life stories and then they make it into a, they make people laugh at it. Or entertained by it. It's a very interesting thing. So, like, what's your style of comedy? Or when I'm fresh, before we get into that, who did you grow up listening to?
I mean, honestly, like I said, comedy was not something I set out to do.
Right.
I did. My brothers would always go when we listened to the Richard Pryor albums, right on the stereo that you would lift out and it go back down. I don't know if you know about that one.
Back when, hey, oh, that's a trip too. That's back when comedians used to sell albums like Eddie Murphy,
right.
Richard Pryor.
That's right.
And that's
you lift up that lid and the stereo system come out and you turn it and put it on. There. Sometimes you need a little penny to make it level because it'll be warm sometimes.
Yeah, with that. Yeah, comedians even had records back in the day. I'll tell you, times have changed.
Man.
Times have changed.
Yeah. So that's what we did, and we would listen to that. And like, that's what I. But as far as somebody like, ooh, I want to pat myself after, or I was like, ooh, I want to. No, I never. That never happened for me. But I do like Ellen. I think Ellen is. Hella funny.
The degenerate?
Yes. I think she's very, very funny. African American females, I don't know if I have one that I would just say, ooh, yeah, I love her. But you know who I like? Gina Yashere.
Out of sticks and locusts and dreams. And to England he came.
Gina Yashere is from Europe. She's a sister from Europe.
Well, she got the English accent.
She got the English accent, the British. Right, and she's funny. She's funny. I don't.
You know, you speaking of that because the British have an interesting sense of comedy. And you know, the thing with British, the British know how to politely offend you.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know it's an offense because their language is so polite.
Right.
But you know, like a female comedian that I really just like love is, well, of course you got Miles Mabry, but what's her name off of Sanford and Son? But she's the one who used to say, you better watch it, sucker.
You know I did not.
Spit fire like Esther on Sanford and Son did. Spit fire like Esther on Sanford and Son did.
Get thee behind me, Satan. But I'm gonna get behind you because I'm gonna put my foot in your
No, I did not know you talking about Esther.
Esther! Oh! It's been fire like Esther on Sanford and Son did.
I did not know she was a comedian until one day when I was going to San Francisco State. She had a show there. And you talking about nasty?
Ooh, cuss word. She was one of the ones known for the cussing.
And, but not even just cussing. She was nasty. She had something under her dress and she pulled it out and it was ready. I was like, oh!
Wait a minute. See, you take your clothes off. That would be first degree ugliness with malice aforethought and attempt to cause blindness.
Ooh. And she was older, like even older than Fred Sanford, you know, when she was on the show.
Talk about improving and getting into your role.
Yeah, so I was like, okay. But yeah, I didn't even know she was a comedian.
Yeah.
Until, yeah, maybe I want to say about 15 years ago. Maybe 15 years ago, yeah.
So okay, when it comes to comedy, right? DC, I'm kind of used to this shit. I do need a script, though, but at least get back to the thing. All right, so, you know, with comedy, right, because there's different styles, you know.
With
the comedy, right, you know, you got like two different styles, you know. Not two different, but, you know, basically, you got the Bill Cosby, Sinbad type comedy, and you got the Eddie Murphy, Richard Pryor type comedy, right?
What is a clean and then it's a dirty.
Yeah, right. Even though I think Bill Cosby. Here's my theory with Bill Cosby on Cosby Show. Right, I think Dr. Huxtable was smoking joints.
You think that's what it was?
Yeah, he was smoking weed. He was smoking weed because look. Oh, this is high shit.
Okay.
You remember when he'd be up in there making the hoagies?
What do you want to do first? You want to eat? Okay. A giant hoagie is full of preservatives and additives, and you may not live as long. Let's try it. Okay. We have salty chips. That'll kill you soon, too. Yes, let's die.
And singing to the hoagies, and that's high shit. That's munchies. But, you know, so, you know, and then, you know, he wasn't all that clean, as we find out with Dr. Huxtable.
He was clean on his own little level. Right, he was clean to us, but then he had his other little side. But everybody does, right?
Well, you know, with Kenan and Kill, because you know, Kenan was like happy to meet him, like how the story goes, just stuff off the internet, you know, maybe lying, maybe tell the truth. But he said, you know, he met Bill Cosby, he respecting, you know, this old wholesome man and stuff. And he said, when he told him off the camera, he said, "You're gonna be fucking all the bitches now." This is what Dr. Huxtable said to.
But what I just say, everybody got this, what they show to the public, right? And then you got another side.
Right.
And so, then some people show it all to the public. Right, and some people don't show none of it at all, ever.
Right. Well, that's an interesting dynamic because like, you know, you got Richard Pryor, who was always kind of like him and Bill was kind of diametrically opposed at times. And it seems like, you know, maybe Bill was hiding. And Richard Pryor was being more truthful,
right?
Even though he was a more dirty mouth one,
right? And then Bill Cosby had the nerve to have an opinion about, you know what I'm saying?
About all of them, Eddie.
Yeah, you know, he had an opinion, which was a negative opinion, but he should have kept. I don't know if that was some type of psychological thing he had going on. You know, subconsciously he knew he was wrong in a whole lot of things that he's done. So yeah, I'll put the people down. A lot of people do that.
Yeah, they do that. They had that split personality,
you know,
type.
You be guilty, right? Don't look at me, because they're doing it all when you are really the culprit, right?
Oh yeah, that's, you know, like a lot of down low brothers that be like that.
Yep.
They be gay bag.
Man.
And then get to him alone in the room with another dude. Oh man. He start getting all like shit.
Why don't you give me some water? It's because you're gonna start out with water.
Right. The villain don't get down like that. Yeah. But back to Bill, right? Here's an interesting thing too with Bill, because see, a lot of people ain't seen Uptown Saturday Night. They say Richard Pryor was like, that's funny you talking about him and Bill Cosby was getting into it, because he actually, You know, he actually studied Bill Cosby. His style was just like Bill Cosby's when he first started. Mm-hmm. And like, you can check it out. It's like, you know, old videos in black and white when he didn't have a mustache. Mm-hmm. He hit the little line right there.
But he evolved into who?
He grew and he elevated.
Yeah. So, I mean, just like anything, you can learn if you have the tenacity and you want, and that's what you really want. I watched a few people do that.
Spit fire like Esther on Saturday, son did. I'm wrong, Luke, more juice, the sun kiss. You want this? So when Jake saying the rhyme, flawless. Shit fly like MJ in his prime. Off the wall with mines, I'm grabbing my balls when I rhyme. Nine nines busting, plus ball all the time.